We will now take a look at the quantity that we ignored so far when we described the hydrodynamic equation, and that is the effect of the magnetic field. So we have some missing terms in the hydrodynamic equations. We have for the equation of motion the effect of the Lorentz force ignored so far, J cross B. And we have in the energy balance the current over the sigma so far ignored. We have the current density just as a repetition, which is the particle charge times the degree of ionization times velocity times number density. So that's basically the fraction of the material or that is actually charged. So to describe these terms, we need to describe the magnetic field. And the magnetic field can be computed through the induction equation. So the partial derivative of the magnetic field with respect to time is in the induction equation given by the curl of the cross product between the velocity and the magnetic field vectors plus the term here including the permeability and the sigma times the Laplace operator of the magnetic field. So when we compute the magnetic field, we now have the problem that our induction equation assumes that the permeability and the sigma term are constants, and this is not true when we look at a compressible gas such as the interstellar medium, because in such under such conditions the density and the ionization degree change with location. And in a moving fluid, this also changes with time as the gas moves along. So to solve this problem, we move to a co-moving reference frame for fluid dynamics, in which we move with every cell of the fluid, with every cell of the gas. In such a co-moving frame, all our material constants can be assumed to be really constant in time. So this requires to transform our induction equation into the co-moving frame. We are looking at electrodynamics in a co-moving frame, and this gives rise then to magnetohydrodynamics. Let's look at the Maxwell equations in an inertial system sigma. We have the first one describing the magnetic field as divergence free. We have the second one describing the curl of the electric field as minus B. So the time derivative of the B field. Then we have the third one ist die Divergence of the Electric Displacement Vector given by the density of the electric charges. And we have the curl of the magnetization given by the density vector plus the time derivative of the displacement vector. When we now move to the co-moving system, we can write our material equations, so the first three equations, in our sigma prime system, so that the primed B vector is the permeability times the magnetization in the primed coordinate system. Our prime displacement vector can be given by the dielectric constant epsilon times the E vector, and the current density in the prime system is the conductivity sigma times our E vector. This only holds in a co-moving system and not in the rest frame. So we now need to transform from sigma to sigma prime. And here we have the problem that our Maxwell equations are invariant for Lorentz transformations, and the hydrodynamic equations are invariant for Galilei transformations. So this does not fit together, and we can only unify these two characteristics when we make the assumption that we're looking at fluid velocities that are much smaller than the speed of light, so that the two transformations are approximately the same. And this is called the classical MHD case. We can then use the Galilei transformation, namely that some location vector r prime is given by the rest frame vector r minus the velocity vector times the time, under the assumption that the time is the same in the two frames. So for the co-moving frame sigma prime, the velocity of at a reference location and reference time 0 is 0. So that means at this reference time and location, the medium in the co-moving frame is at rest. This is actually the definition of the co-moving frame. And a typo here. Now, as I said, neglecting the relativistic terms, we want to transform our field equation. And we do this by using the following approach. We are looking at the Lorentz force on a particle with a charge q in the moving frame. So this was the force. The Lorentz force is given by the charge of the particle times the electric field. So that's the Coulomb part, plus the Lorentz force, which is just the cross product of the velocity of the charge cross the magnetic field. So in our rest frame, our charge is at rest with zero velocity, so the only force our particle feels in the co-moving frame is the Coulomb force. So with that, we see that the electric force in the electric field in the co-moving frame is given by the electric field at rest plus the Lorentz force. And this can equivalently be written down for all field equations. So looking at the displacement vector, transformed is the untransformed displacement vector plus 1 over c squared and the cross product of the velocity with the magnetization. The h prime can be written as the untransformed h minus the Lorentz contribution given by the deep displacement vector, and the b prime can be given by b minus 1 over c squared velocity cross the electric field. And here you can see where the factor 1 over c squared comes from. We can also transform our expression for the current density, which is in the transformed system the difference between the untransformed J and the electrical charge density times the velocity. Of course, if we transform in a velocity frame such that the charges are at rest, the current density is reduced, of course. Alternatively, we can also transform the charge density, which is the untransformed one, minus, of course, the 1 over c squared term, times the velocity times the current density. So in the untransformed system, our currents, our moving charges, turn into charges at rest when we transform, of course, in an exactly co-moving system. And this has to be accounted for in the Maxwell equations. And this is done by this set of transformation equations. So you have to compare, for example. On the other hand, if you have a particle that is at rest in the standard system, you have an electric field, so the electric field lines here, and when you transform to the prime system, you now have a moving charge that induces magnetic field lines. So, using the transformations, we rewrite our material equations. So we have the b vector minus 1 over c squared, cross product of the velocity with the electric field, can be described in terms of the magnetization and the minus and the velocity cross the displacement vector. The displacement vector can be expressed in terms of the electric field vector minus the Lorentz force contribution and the current density minus the charge current here can be given by sigma E minus velocity cross B. When we combine this with our Maxwell equations, we get this set of equations in the co-moving frame that describes the behavior of the fluid. So we have the four Maxwell equations, we have the three material equations. This gives us seven differential equations. And we can simplify this, but to simplify this, we need stronger assumptions, stronger than just looking at non-relativistic velocities. And this is described in the part about the MHD approximations.